70% of the crimes that these children commit, they're with an adult.
That's right.
And it seems like to me that there's not equity in as far as the sentencing of an adult and a child. But one thing that my supervisor at the time that I worked in Tuscola Schools, she would say, well, children don't vote and children don't have money.
Yeah.
And so what we have here is this atrocity against kids, because that child was just as much a victim as those people that he victimized, and there was a specific reason for why that was done, because he was threatened and his family was threatened. But that seemed to not have had any bearing on how they sentenced this child. And I think it's attractive for everybody to see an adult, the guy that, the 24-year-old, just get the one sentence and he get four. Mm-hmm. And there's something wrong with that picture. When on Saturday in the 74126 zip code in North Tulsa Health Department, that's how we found out about this, Monroe Nichols, which is who is our new representative, spoke to us about the prison reform bill that the state or people overwhelmingly said that they wanted reform in Oklahoma. But there's one person that's holding this bill up, Scott Biggs, whatever his name is. But this one person is holding it up because he's a chairman of the committee. A law cannot be passed until it goes to the committee and brought to the floor.
Oh, that's
so it's
right.
It's as if, you know, whether we're the people, it really doesn't matter, because you can vote for whatever you want. We can have 99% of the people in Oklahoma say that they want to have a change in the way that we sentence people or so forth and so on. But you have people that are consistently put in those positions that say, well, they don't want that, and they will not bring it. And I think the other guy that was like his understudy that's under him, he was just picked up for prostituting a young man, 16-year-old. I can't remember his name. But I'm like, so these are the people that represent you and
Republicans,
us or whatever. And, you know, they're not held accountable for what they do. So how do we expect them to do what justly towards the people that that we consider precious? Because I consider that young man precious. Because I would have, had I been a judge, but I'm not, but had I been a judge, I would have wanted to say that child was probably detached. If his mother on drugs, he never was really attached to that woman. But whoever even think about that, was that part of the reason why he was in survival mode?
Sure.
But who cares about that? And so, you know, we're so stuck on our politics and somebody being a winner and somebody being a loser that when it's all said and done, we all lose. You think that somebody's winning and somebody's losing, but really, we're all losing.
Well, even the fact what he said, the mother said that he was with his sister, and here he's 11 and his sister's
15.
15, yeah.
Still a child.
Yeah, and nobody points that up. But that's probably
just to kind of dovetail on what she was saying,